Boom. Annie! Bonjour! Kwe Kwe! Sago! Tansi, my brothers and sisters! My name is Carolyn, and I come from Mi'kma'ki territory, from the East Coast, known today as Nova Scotia. But Tuckahoronto has been my home since a young child, and so I welcome you, everyone. And I also want to acknowledge these folks behind me that stand with me in solidarity. They're my friends. Woo! And family. I know that I Don't Know More Toronto is here supporting this action. I'm so thankful to see so many youth and people from many cultures from around the world in this diverse city at this moment, at this march. In our prophecy, this is the time that the youth will rise. And all of us need to stand together with them to be able to protect the coming generations of all beings. We are in a critical time. Our Mother Earth is being harmed. Our lands are burning. The waters are rising. Animals and other beings are disappearing because people have fallen out of relationship with her. The colonial mindset sees the land and waters as a resource, something that is fueled by greed and power. It's all about taking from the land without giving back. And that impacts all of us. At one point in time, all of our ancestors were in deep relationship with the land. We need to return back home to that relationship. We need to prioritize building loving and reciprocal relationships with all beings. Indigenous people of Turtle Island have been in deep relationship with Mother Earth since time immemorial. We believe she provides all that is needed for optimal well-being for all of us. She is our teacher, our healer, our companion, and more. What happens to her impacts all of us. It is time for real change. We need to reconstruct our global food systems as they are failing. One third of all food produced in the world is wasted or lost. 23% of all greenhouse gases are caused by agriculture, raising cattle, and deforestation. A half of all methane produced is caused by cattle and rice production. We need to pressure politicians to adopt the UN Declaration of Indigenous Rights. We need to stand with Indigenous people who are defending and protecting the water and the lands, as they are doing it for all beings. We need to take action with our dollars by supporting ethical businesses. So before you spend your dollar, look into that corporation and see what they're doing to help protect the planet. We need to stop and use alternatives for plastic. We need to say no to development in the Greenbelt, where it's fruitful farmland. We need to take time in our everyday lives to practice gratitude, to think about all those beings that are connected to our food, including the waters, the fires, the winds. And take that time, because gratitude is universal. Whether someone is religious, spiritual, or not, we can all practice this gratitude. I invite you to find a spot near your home, school, or workplace, and go to that spot at least once a week on the land, and at least sit there for 30 minutes or more. And what will happen is you will start to build a relationship with that spot. I have a spot because I live across from High Park. I've been going there for over 10 years. And I'll tell you, when I first started there, you know, I greeted all those beings because they are our relatives. And over the years, I noticed a tiny white pine sapling peeking out through the leaves at the bottom of the ground. and I greeted that white pine. That white pine now is at least 15 feet tall. I've watched that white pine grow up. I am protective of that white pine. It's the only selfie that I have in my cell phone is me and white pine like this. And so I also want to let you know about something that's happening on October 13th at 1 o'clock. We want you to join us for a healing ceremony that's happening. We are going to be gathering around Grenadier Park, Grenadier Pond around in High Park for a healing ceremony, because we know that the glyphosates have been being sprayed and applied into that park as well as across the city. The World Health Organization, Cancer's Agency, has known that this is a possible carcinogenic, that there are many lawsuits in the United States against the Bayer parent company that is owned by the Roundup. So we need to gather together and pressure them. And so we invite you all to come and join us. And so just so you know, we have a an email, indigenouslandstewardshipto@gmail.com. We need thousands of people so we can hold hands around that pond and do a healing ceremony for all those beings, because it impacts all of us. And the one final thing I want to say is we need to let politicians and corporations know that the whole world is watching. Say it with me. The whole world is watching. 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 Chimigwech, Walalio.